Oh. Do we still have the stand?
Yeah, here. Here, let me come here.
I'm not one of those that jumps around.
You need help?
No. I let the Holy Spirit do that.
Everyone,
God is good, amen.
Amen.
We before he became a man, the Word of God. In fact, that's one of his names in the book of Revelation. His name is the Word of God. Revelation 19. That he was the Logos, the reason. He is the express image of God. When he became a man, that was God becoming a man. Why did he become a man? Well, he became a man because man could not redeem himself. God requires perfection, amen. To enter into his kingdom, you have to be perfect. Well, there's no man on the face of the earth that is perfect. There was, at one time, Adam. But he blew it, didn't he? He disobeyed God. From that point on, there was none righteous. No, not one. So Jesus Christ agreed, in full agreement with the Father and the Holy Spirit, that he would take on human flesh. He had to take on human flesh. God had to become a man in order to become the Lamb of God. In order to be slain by God on behalf of the sins of all that the Father gave unto him, he had to become a man, didn't he? Now we know Jesus was not able to sin, being that he was God. And by the way, if you don't believe Jesus Christ was and is God, you have no Savior. You have no Savior. Mohammed cannot save you. He was a sinner just like you and me. Confucius could not save you, sinner. Buddha, sinner. Joseph Smith, sinner. Okay. The list goes on and on. Russell, Charles Taze Russell, founder of Jehovah's Witnesses, sinner. Claim to be inspired by God. You couldn't understand the Bible apart from his writings because he was the prophet. These are all sinners. The difference between them and Jesus Christ is Jesus Christ was not a sinner. He was God. And one preacher pointed as God, Jesus Christ was unable to sin. Agree with that? But as a man, he was able not to sin. And trust you me that he experienced every temptation known under the sun. Yet he never gave way to any one of them. Could you imagine being in presence of Christ, knowing that he is God? Jesus himself said in John 8:24, that unless you believe I am, you will die in your sin. Unless you believe I am the great I am, you have no Savior. Emmanuel, Isaiah called, God with us. Not a God, but Jehovah God with us. The Lamb of God. Hebrews says that God prepared him a body. The Father was the one who actually prepared the body for the Lord. And the Holy Spirit, the one who did the miraculous conception of bringing Christ into the egg of Mary, the Virgin Mary. Now she was a sinner too. But Jesus Christ was not. I'm going to read you this little gospel tract I made these. And I'll leave a few here with you for those of you who are interested in having one for yourself or taking one or two and handing them to people you know. It's entitled, Come Unto Me. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. You know, so many people try to find rest through the things of the world. Money, alcohol, women, drugs, power. because of Adam's transgression. The book of Romans says that by one man sin entered into the world. That's Adam. You became a sinner by virtue of Adam, not because you sinned. You're a sinner because you were born a sinner. Okay? But there is no rest and satisfaction in those things. That empty hole has to be filled by God. He's the only one who can fill it. Namely, Christ. Because you have no access to God the Father but through Jesus Christ. You can't go through Muhammad. Okay? Muhammad was not a savior. He was not a man of God. When Muhammad died, that was heaven. When Jesus Christ died, because his body was the veil. You hear that? His body was the veil. When he died, that veil and temple got torn in half, didn't it? Because his body was broken. His body was broken. That's why we do the Lord's Supper. The bread represents the broken body of the Lord. Okay? Now we have access into the Holy of Holies, into the very presence of God. We have greater access to God than Adam and Abraham and Isaac and David and so on and so on. Because they were waiting for access. They believed God was sent the Messiah, but yet sent him. They were saved by faith, just like you and I, by faith through grace. But they didn't have the power of the Holy Spirit living in them. The Holy Spirit tried to come upon them and empower them, such as Samson and Elijah and, you know, his great men, David. He didn't take up residence in them. Well, all was written on stone. That was a great man. But it's even greater now if it's written in your heart. Amen. Written in your heart. I don't need two tablets of stone. I know what's right and what's wrong. Holy Spirit, by birth of the Holy Spirit, lets me know. Amen. You ever take your stomach and twist it into knots and you're about to do something that's not right? Amen. You ever felt that? You need to be obedient to that, don't you? Hebrews said, if you hear his voice today, harden not your heart. The children of Israel did. You want to waste your life wandering around circles, doing the same thing, drugs, alcohol, women, money. You know what the Bible says about that? That the fool chases those things. Jesus called you a fool if that's what you chase. I did, but I can by virtue of the scripture. But Jesus Christ said, thou fool, your soul is required of you this very night. And you wasted your entire life chasing the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and pride of life. At some point you have to say, enough's enough, amen. I'm not going to be conquered by sin anymore. Romans 6:14, one of the greatest verses in the Bible. For sin shall not have dominion over you. Only applies to born again Christian, amen. Sin shall not have dominion over you. Why? If you're not under the law can't condemn you anymore. You're under grace. What then? Shall we sin because we're not under the law, under grace? God forbid. God forbid. How can we, who are dead to sin, live any longer therein? No. You don't have a license to sin when you become a Christian. You have a license not to sin. Amen. Let's get it straight. Oh, I'm glory. Yeah, I've been wrapped up. Yeah, I'm different. Man, what would I do? You know what that water can do for you? Wash the dirt off your skin. That's it. It doesn't save you. No water doesn't save you. Nothing holy about that water. Lame man, Gospel of John, been laying on his bed for 38 years, waiting for the waters to move, for some man to come bring down in the water, because the angel would come down periodically and stir the waters. Anybody got any water? When the angel was stirring waters, he'd be healed. Jesus came up to that man and said, you be made whole. The man said, sir, I have no man. evil guy. You're a man. You call him a man, right? Yeah, you are a man. A man cannot help you or save you or deliver you or heal you. But a man, take up that bed of water. Immediately, the man took up the bed of water. Don't turn to man for the answer to your problems. Amen? Turn to the one who created man. Take my yoke upon you, learn me, find me, lowly in heart. Ye shall find rest unto your souls. My yoke is easy, my burden is light. Matthew 11:28-30. Know anything about that? My yoke is easy, my burden is light. You don't know anything about that until you become born again. Until your sins are relieved from you. The burden of sin. And until the weight of the law that is hanging over your head is crushing you is removed. After me, 23 years ago, never been the same since. Felt like 1,000 pounds was removed from my back. Why would Christ command us to come unto Him? After all, aren't there other ways to heaven besides Jesus? God's answer is emphatic no. There are not. Christ Himself claimed to be the only way to heaven, as found in John 14:6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. That's settled it, doesn't it? Neither is there salvation, Acts 4:12, in any other. For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. That further settles it, doesn't it? I mean, a child can understand that, amen? This eliminates all other false man-made religions, such as Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, Mormonism, Jehovah's Witness, Catholicism, New Age, Unitarianism, witchcraft, etc., all of which are based on human merit, not on Christ alone. Man-made religion can't save you. I don't care what it is, what form or fashion it is. There's no redemption in it. If they have no Savior, it's a problem. Mormonism, Jehovah's Witness, say, we believe Jesus was a man. He became a God, but no, he wasn't God Almighty. But you have no Savior. Because God requires perfection. You must be perfect in order to have your sin covered by virtue of Jesus Christ. That's the only way that you can become perfect in the sight of God, is by virtue of Jesus Christ in love. And He must be God. If Jesus committed one single sin at any moment, point in time in His life, there is no Savior in the world. We're all going to hell. Thank God He didn't. Amen. So who exactly is Jesus Christ? Well, He's the second person of the divine Godhead, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Three persons of one God. You say, where is that? But who can say Trinity? Doesn't have to say Trinity anywhere in the Bible. Jesus said, go and baptize in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Spirit. They have three persons, amen. Yes, the Holy Spirit is all over the New Testament. He's even in the Old Testament, too. Let us make man in our image. Well, that's more important, isn't it? Us? Yes, it is. You talk to Jehovah's Witnesses in the morning, they said, that was referring to the angels. Nowhere in Scripture is the sign angels creating power. Nowhere. Our image. Created our image. Image of God, amen. We're not created in the image of the angels. One day we'll be like the angels when we die and go to heaven. But we will not ever be angels. We're not created in the image of angels. We're created in the image and likeness of God. Now, unfortunately, when Adam sinned, the image of God was lost. Likeness is still there. Why? Because man is like
saved, really, really, I say unto you that before Abraham was, I am. Now, only God can say that, amen? Before Abraham was, I am. He's claiming eternal existence. You understand that? John 8:58. Before Abraham was, I am. He said, 94 years old. He said, before Abraham was, I am. Now that's it. They didn't want to accept it though, did they? No. Because they didn't want God. They had their silly little man-made religion. Big eyes, little ewes, you know, Pharisees running around, long robes. Looking good, whitewashed. Jesus called it whitewashed wall, but inside it's full of dead man's bones. Now, it takes more than man-made religion. It takes a Savior. Here we see him as the very same I am who told Moses to tell Israel who has sent him. In Exodus 3:13-14. Again, we see in John 10:30, I and the Father are one. That's stating equality with God. Oneness. Look it up for yourself in Greek. It is the same essence. That's what he's saying. I and the Father are one of the same essence. We're one. Have always existed with the Father. In fact, this is why the Jews tried to stone Jesus on more than one occasion. They ultimately had him crucified. Here, quote, John 10:33. The Jews answered him, for a good work he stole thee not, but for blasphemy, and because thou being a man, makest thyself God. That was the whole charge. He made himself God. And they said, we ain't having it. You don't make yourself God. You call yourself the Son of God. You call yourself I am. We're going to eliminate you. No. Doesn't work that way. You don't eliminate God. God eliminates you. Man can't do anything. You don't fear man. Fear him who created man, who's able to destroy body and soul in hell, amen? There's no man that can point you and destroy you in hell, but God can. In fact, you can't do anything apart from God. You know what they're saying? Free will. You know that? If there were, God would not be sovereign, now would he? If there were anything free in this world, God would not be sovereign. He would not be God. You understand that? Pretty simple, isn't it? Whoa, how we love to think we're free. Amen. There's these religious thoughts of free will value. It's not free. If you feel anything free in this world, turn from the sovereignty of God, God would not be sovereign. Whatever that was that was free, that would be sovereign. Say, why do people go to hell? God's sovereign. Well, does God not have the right? Read Romans 10:9. Did God not have the right to create one vessel for honor and one for dishonor? Huh? Can the pot say to the potter, why did you call me this way? God has every right in the world to destroy and to save. The mystery is not why did God send people to hell. The mystery is why did God save anyone? Amen? We're filthy. We're wretched. We're wicked. We're sinful. We're repulsive and revulsive in the sight of God. We're worse than the worm of the ground. The worm of the ground don't rebel against God. They do His will, don't they? Oh, man is sinful. That's the whole problem. He's not only sinful, but he's dead. He's spiritually dead unto God. Why do we really need Jesus? God's word tells us, 1 Corinthians 15:22, for as in Adam all die. All die in Adam. Not just Adam, but all die. All mankind die when Adam died. When Adam sinned. said, you who were spiritually dead in sin and trespasses, guess what? God made alive. God quit. But you were dead. You got to understand that. You're not born again. You don't know God. You got to understand one thing. That is, you're dead after God. You need to be made alive. Shall all who believe be made alive. We are sinners by the word of our own human nature, and so dead to God. We are made alive by God, the Holy Spirit. And you have me, the Holy Spirit, with you, who are dead in sin and trespasses, Ephesians 2:1. If you desire to go to heaven when you die, if you would like to have all your sin forgiven, if you don't want to spend all eternity burning in hell, for your unpaid for sin, by the way, that's what sends a man to hell. It's not that he was a murderer or a thief or a liar or adulterer or, rejecting Christ. That's not what sends him to hell. What sends him to hell is that his sins are not paid for. Because even after you become born again, you can commit a lot of heinous sins, can't you? You can commit adultery, you can be a thief, you can lie, you can murder. Now God won't let you do it visually, but you will do something. Jesus says, you can look at a woman and lust after her, guess what? You committed adultery in your heart. You don't have to touch her. You just have a lustful power. You're guilty of adultery. Same goes true for coveting. Oh, I like that car. Man, that's a nice car. Woo, I'd like to have that. You're guilty of coveting. And idolatry. Oh, I love KFC Chiefs. Man, I feel for the Chiefs, You're an idolater. If that's how you think. You glued to the television, all you live for is sports. You're guilty of idolatry. You made sports an idol in your life. It has to be crushed, amen. Television is very dangerous, I'm here to tell you. Very dangerous. If the devil is the one who kind of whole man, he brainwash you. He'll get a hold of your brain and make you think the way he wants you to think. It's a way to manipulate the mass, the multitudes. Tell me, nearly everybody has one in their house. You sit in front of that thing just for an hour or whatever, your mind is going to be off. Thank Christ, off. Thank the world. It's that simple. Say, oh, I like watching the nature shows or the news or, Can't you look at the world, look at nature? Can't you go outside and look at nature? Can't you read the newspaper, or why you have to be glued to television? I call it television. That's what it is. You put your mind on the things above, what Colossians tells you, not on the things of this world. See, why are the Puritans so godly, man? How are they so profound? John Owen, Thomas Watson, John Cowan, all these guys. They didn't waste their mind on television, amen. They didn't have no television. They didn't waste their mind on the internet. Looking around on Amazon, eBay, all that. Ooh, I can have that. No. You need to keep your mind on the things above. Keep your mind on Christ, amen. You must be born again by God the Holy Spirit. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. John 3:3. You're not going to get in. You can't even see it unless you be born again. Now, a few of us who actually devote our lives to Christ, pursuing Christ and His Word, who actually get a glimpse now, here in this life, of the kingdom. Amen. I'm not saying get some special revelation or have some resort or anything like that. But you are getting to know, if you devote, commit your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, to His Word, you will get to know what the kingdom of heaven is about. Amen. Namely, the fruit of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, gentleness, kindness, meekness, temper, self-control. Just to name a few. You know, you can't live without your TV. What do you think heaven's going to be like? Think there's going to be a big screen up in heaven and watch the Chiefs up there? There'll be no heaven. There'll be no television in heaven. You can't, you know, go one day without smoking or drinking or, you know, looking at naked women on the computer or magazine, whatever. You think you're going to fit into heaven? Think you're going to actually, you wouldn't even enjoy it in heaven. Heaven is a place of purity. Like they said, there's a road. It's a holy road and nothing impure. Well, get on. Highway to heaven. I know some like sing that song, Highway to Heaven. It's not biblical. Where he said. There is a highway to heaven, but it's through the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. I don't know where to get that, but there is a highway to hell, too. There's a kiss. AC/DC, highway to hell. They're singing like they're ready to jump on in there. You idiots, you do not know what you're saying. You don't understand what you are saying. They don't. The world doesn't. They treat God, God's word, Christ, with contempt, just like the Jews did. Oh, you're just a man, dude. You don't know his name. No, this man, he didn't go to rabbinical school, but yet he schooled every one of you when he was 12 years old. They were asking him questions when he was just a child. And they were going through something once a year to present their Passover. Jesus said, do you not know I'm eating my Father's house? Where's your life at? Well, what are you seeking? Are you seeking the things of God? Are you still in love with the things of the world? Where God said, if any man love the world or things in the world, the love of the Father is not in him. You're not saved. When you get saved, there needs to be a transformation has to take place. You have to leave the world like God left Sodom. Unfortunately, his wife looked back, didn't she? But you know what happened to her? She turned into a pillar of salt. What does it mean to be born again? It means that you have been made alive by God, the Holy Spirit. This happens when and if you truly believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that He died for your sins, rose again on the third day. You must believe that He is who He claimed to be and has always been, namely God Almighty. If Jesus is not God, then we have no Savior. God the Father, earth, man without sin. Unblemished. Lamb of God. Back in the Old Testament, when they were present their sacrifices, if any of the animals had any kind of blemish, they were not sure about them. Not allowed to be sacrificed. Okay? And God said, you don't drink the blood. Why? Because the blood was for one reason. Make atonement for sin. To be sprinkled on the altar to make the altar holy. And without shedding blood, there's no forgiveness, no remission of sin. Jesus Christ had to become a man, He had to die. His blood had to be spilled. God's blood had to be spilled in order for our sins to be atoned for, paid for. No, He did not die for sins of the whole world. If He did, the whole world would go to heaven. The whole world would not go to heaven. Hey, what about that? What do you think? God who loved the world, He gave His own God's Son. That whoever believes will not perish. We have given unto me. Now lose not one. Now lose not one. I mean, you can't lose your salvation. Once you become saved, you're saved. You don't save yourself. Philippians 1:6. For God, who is at work in you, for God who began a good work in you, he will perfect it until the day of Christ. For it is God who is at work in you, both will and do, according to his own good will, his own good pleasure. It's God who is at work in you.
Amen.
You can do nothing apart from me. John 15:5. In him we move and live and have our being. Acts 17. You wouldn't even exist apart from the Lord Jesus Christ. Do you know that? He brought everything into existence, including you. And then you have this nerve and audacity to think, oh, you're just a big shot. You're going to do it as you please. You don't need Christ. You don't need God. The Bible calls you a fool. How can a created being shake their fist at the one that created? And Chris, you know, I found a digging around up my attic area. I found this old letter from 1919. My house, 1905. My name's Bill. This letter, 1919, almost 100 years ago. And the lady writing the letter, she wrote to the woman who lived in my current house 100 years ago. And she was talking about one of her daughters, and something less than happened to her. She killed herself or something. And she said, God will forgive her, but we will not. Statement, isn't it? For whatever this girl did, you know, she died, as she said in the letter. She's at rest now and whatnot. She's referring to her being at rest and didn't have to battle the cold and all that stuff that they had to struggle with. But that statement, God will forgive her, but we will not. Yeah. The Bible says if you don't forgive, your fellow man, God will not forgive you. Forgiveness is an attribute of somebody who has been forgiven. Amen. The reason you can't forgive is because you haven't been forgiven. Make sense? Pretty logical, isn't it? Well, this is the gospel of Christ, that you believe on him and you turn from your sin, which is Romans 5. Okay? And if I believe on Jesus, well, why do you keep on doing the same stupid stuff? Why do you keep getting drunk and high and chasing women? Your faith is not the same as faith. If it was, your life would be changed. You would have repentance mixed with your faith. Because faith, as James says, faith without works or without repentance is what? Dead. There is such a thing as a dead faith. Yeah, I believe in Jesus. I got this problem right now. That won't save you. The demons believe in Jesus. They know he's real. Are they saved? No way. They can't be saved. Okay, the angels cannot be saved. It's not, they are not able to be saved. They cannot be born again. They have no, Jesus did not die for the angels. Jesus did not become an angel. That's another thing that the false post Mormonism and drove with it. Yeah, he was an angel. Michael the Archangel. Jesus was not Michael the Archangel. Where did he get that? Oh, Revelation, the angel. Michael the Archangel, he was born with the dragon. Where did it say Jesus Christ was that Michael the Archangel? He was born with the dragon. Doesn't. Just a lie. It's a false religion. You know how many millions of people have been taken by false religion? Why? Because they don't know the Bible. That's the reason why. They tried to get me before I got saved. seen the Mormon fellow in me? The God I didn't know. It's only by the grace of God that I didn't fall into it. And I didn't know my Bible back then. I believe in God. I didn't know Christ personally. As the body cannot live without the soul, so the soul cannot live to God without Christ. John Owen actually said that. You ever get a chance to grab some of his writings, you won't be disappointed. You know that man wrote over 4,000 pages just from the book of Hebrews. 4,000. That's pretty prodigious, isn't it? And we can't even write one sentence. Can't even memorize one verse. You know, you need to give your mind to the Word of God. If you believe in God, in fact, be a Christian, your mind needs to be given to the Word of God. And start your day with the Word of God. Think about the Word of God all through the day. And end your day with the Word of God. Amen? Jesus said, unless you eat of me, you have no life. Jesus is the Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, was the written God, was the Word of God. Jesus, all that provided exists by Him. And without Him, nothing exists. He is the Word of God. When you read the Word of God, study the Word of God, you're eating on the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. The early Christians were accused of cannibalism because they were going up there and they were eating the body of the Lord. Well, body of the Lord, they weren't eating physical body of the Lord. Physical body of the Lord is in heaven right now. He's in a real physical body. He always will be for all eternity. Okay? And yet He is everywhere in spirit. Because He's one. He's one. He's there's three persons of one God, but He is one with all the Spirit. But the Holy Spirit lives in you, and Christ lives in you too, by virtue of the Holy Spirit. And so does the Father. Okay? There's three that you can pray to. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You don't pray to any other person than those three. Don't pray to Mary. Don't pray to, you know, Allah. It's not the God of the Bible. It's not Jehovah. Okay? Pray to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I am the bread of life. He that cometh unto me shall never hunger. He that believeth on me shall never thirst. John 6:35. Here, it says right here, play. I'm bread of life. This plate. Now, the reason why this plate can say I'm bread of life, because scripture is bread of life. When you eat that plate, the plate ain't gonna save you. Even if there was a loaf of bread on there, it wouldn't save you. See, in reference to the Lord Jesus Christ, He is the bread of life. He is the living water. If you eat of Him, you drink of Him, He's the well that never runs dry. You know, the woman at the well, she came well for this water. Jesus said, you would have known who it was you're talking to, I would have given you living water. She didn't know what she was doing or what she was saying. But she did later, didn't she? Later she did, Jesus set us up. She said, yeah, we're waiting for the Messiah. We know He's going to come one of these days. And Jesus looked at her. She says, He who speaks with you, I am. I am the Messiah. The Jews still wait for the Messiah to come while they're in Israel, aren't they? I give so better. Supporters of Israel, have I sent all my money over Israel? Why should I send my money to a nation that's rejected my Messiah? Ain't gonna happen. They're just as bad as the United States. In that regard, we rejected the Messiah. Yeah, well, they're saying, now we trust them. Yeah, well, we're here to talk to money. Should be in the Almighty deal we trust, not God. We are not a nation as a whole that fears God. We do not fear God. If we did, we wouldn't be killed. killing over a billion babies every year, making it legal. Whoever did that,
they're going to be in some serious hellfire if they didn't repent of their sins. The abortion caucus, man, they got a hot spot in hell. Boy, I'm killing God's children like that. I'm just about to realize. Why do people go to hell? Because their sins have not been paid for. Jesus not died for the sins of the whole world, but the whole world go to him. He died for the sins of all the common here. I ain't covered that. John 6:37, all that the Father shall give to me, and him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me. And him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. Salvation is a gift of God, amen. By grace through faith, you've been saved, but not on your own. It's a gift of God. That's the amen, suppose. This is the gospel. If you believe in Jesus Christ as God, he died to make payment for your sins, your will to repent of your sins, then thou shalt be saved. You will have proved yourself to be one of God's children and elect children. If you do not, you'll prove yourself to be a child of the devil. You will die in your sins, i.e., you will be sentenced to hell for all eternity. Man's problem is that he's in a spiritual state of death to God. As Isaiah 7:59, verse 2, but your iniquities or sins have separated between you and your God, your sins have hid his face from you. Your sins have hid the face of God from you. Friend, Christ is the only hope to be saved from the wrath of God. Believe in him today, and so your sins shall be washed away. I am Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end, Revelation 22:13. Bless you, hear my voice, and they will come. John 10:27. If you belong to the Lord, if you've been chosen by God, guess what? You're going to come. You're not a single soul in hell. God looked down, oh, I wish I could have saved that one. That's not how God operates. God knew. He knew what man needed. He needed a Savior. He needed a perfect Lamb of God. He knew it. He provided it. He made payment on the behalf of all the Father gave it to him. Well, I hope you take it to heart. Take God's word to heart. Let us go to God and word of prayer, and I can answer your question after the sermon. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for your goodness, grace, love, and mercy in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. You've been merciful and abundant in grace towards us who believe. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your perfect obedience, coming, becoming a man, and taking our sins, the sins of all upon him and you upon yourself. We praise you and love you, Lord. Thank you for being in control of every person, thing, creature, creation, this whole world you created. We don't have to worry about what's going to happen to us today or tomorrow. We know you've got it all on your hand. You're in control of all. You are sovereign. We thank you and praise you. We bow down unto you now. We know your word says that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We know that will happen. We pray, oh God, we might do that even right now, right here today. These poor souls don't have to do it in hell. Now you might reveal yourself unto them, just please on your side and your will. Their sins may be placed on the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. You might deliver those who belong to you from their spiritual darkness. Open their eyes this day, delivering from the vices of the flesh, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, the pride of life, alcohol, tobacco, drugs, sex, money, immorality, whatever it is. Sin shall not have dominion over us. We've been delivered. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. Help us, Holy Spirit, overcome our old man, our old nature. Completely overcome him. Teach us how to ask you to overcome all old man each and every day of our lives. We're apart from you, we can do nothing. Teach us to rely on you. You to overcome our old sinful nature. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
that in this facility, may have a blessing upon the workers, Brother Alex, and these kind gentlemen who are devoting their time to this facility. May have a blessing, protect, peace to our love, compassion be rested upon them. These men will be obedient unto these superiors. There will be no chaos or confusion in this facility, but that you will be Lord, Lord, King of Kings. People will respect this place that you have given them as a time of rest. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Gentlemen,